Hello. Today I will speak about transcultural psychiatry, challenges with immigrant families and their children. So the contents of this course, context of immigration and some concepts underlying our approach, then clinical approach and research challenges, then psychotherapeutic setting with immigrant families, and then we will finish with mental health program in humanitarian fields. So first, our field in France, in Bobigny, at the Seine Hospital in the northeastern multicultural outskirts of Paris, and then in Paris, in the center of Paris, Cochin Hospital, Maison de Solène, upper white middle classes. In all this context, multicultural and transcultural issues occur in all cities and all social classes. I think that is true for Europe, but also for the world alike. So you can see Avicenne Hospital and then Cochin Hospital, Maison de Solène. So our context about immigration, there are children mostly born in Europe, first, second and third generation of immigrants and new refugees. And our population serve, one quarter of the population are immigrant patients from Maghreb countries, so all the Maghreb countries, the other quarter from West Africa, Mali, Senegal, Mauritania and so on. One quarter from Central Africa, Cameroon, Congo, Brazzaville and all these kind of countries, and one quarter from other countries, Turkey, Georgia, Pakistan, India, Sri Lanka, China, Vietnam and many others. So in these two consultations we spoke last year 26 different languages in these consultations, so there are a lot of languages. So why cultural issues are so important in our world? We know that from a long time, and we know that importance of mental health needs all around the world are not only in the West. First point. Second point is that the cross-cultural comparative studies show that in the impact of social and cultural differences, and also the fact that psychiatric diagnoses are not universal. And the research has made clear too that ethnic minorities may systematically receive a lower quality of health care than non-minorities. And the last fact is that these disparities are related to stereotyping, cultural biases and uncertainty of the part of the healthcare provider. These transcultural points are very important for the adult, but also for child and mental health programs. Why? Because in child and mental health programs, the languages and the cultural barriers may lead to misdiagnosis too. Because also there are difficulties in the therapeutic alliance with the children and the family. Sometimes there is no compliance, but also low efficacy of treatment. So it is very important and challenging to work with interpreters and to increase the transcultural sensitivity of assessment and treatment. The definition of culture is also very important. We know that culture is a philosophical and pragmatic system made up of languages, representation and belief, family structure, system of parenthood and parenting, techniques of, and ways of doing things, clothing, cooking, art, healing, being a mother and so on. So, and it's the main point, it's a dynamic system that is always changing. The effect of immigration, now we know them, for individuals, loss, violence, trauma, grief, depression and anxiety as the main point for individuals, but also for groups, the immigration has effect on the groups, lack of support, of ties, difference in value, languages and religions, and also, it's important point for children, the effect of immigration for parenthood with loneliness, different parenting style, for example. So on parenthood and parenting, the main point is that first, lack of the cultural framework for the parents, lack of the support of the community and the previous generation, stigmatization and racism. And the point is not to lose self-esteem because they are different and belonging to minorities. So we have to promote agency for the parents and the importance of mother tongue. Bilingualism might not be a problem for the children, but it's important that the parents are able to transmit this mother tongue. So it's for the father and mother, and now for the children. The children have to go through inside to outside. Inside, you know, some parameters that are very important inside: family privacy, mother tongue, rituals, upbringing, values, habits, explanation, food, family relation, rules. And outside, with other language, school, education, food, explanation, friends, doctors and hospitals that are different, of course, and that represent outside, otherness or racism. So they have to go from inside to outside. And this process lead to transcultural vulnerability. The vulnerability of the children, of immigrant children, are connected to the context where the children grow up. There is a split between outside and inside, and this split leads to developmental vulnerability, as the research showed. So, transcultural situation is a risk for the children. The second point in this transcultural field is a cross-cultural validity. We know now that there is different experiences and expression of distress. In the DSM-5, we can see that there is more cultural sensitivity. For example, there is an outline for cultural formulation and a glossary of cultural Brown syndrome. But it's not still enough. We need methods and criteria that have to be translated, not only translation of words, but also meanings and connotation. And it's the same for the test. Test and self-assessment questionnaire that are used in research have been developed on Western subjects and are not appropriated for use among ethnic minorities patients because they lack of equivalence. So we can say that we still lack a true international epidemiology. The third point is what to do, transcultural psychotherapeutic setting. So now in the world it exists different method to do psychotherapeutic setting, to do psychotherapy in this transcultural context. We use the complementarism that is the founder is Devereux in the Menninger Clinic in Kansas City in US, and is the fact to use psychiatry, psychoanalysis or psychotherapy and another discipline like anthropology or linguistic or history. And we need to do that on a complementarism way. And there are different psychotherapeutic strategies in Canada, in France, in Holland, but I will summarize them in this table. So transcultural psychiatry, the first point is to defend and to accept psychological universality. We are all the same. Psychological universality, but also cultural coding is universal through we vary it. So, psychological universality and cultural coding. We need to think about them at the same time. Individual and cultural parameters have to be taken into account, and also complementarism, as I say, at least two techniques, and also to use and to analyze and to recognize cultural transference and counter-transference. And also, we know that psychological resistance to diversity exists and we have to cope with. So, in this transcultural setting, different services are offered. First, group session with several therapists, I will speak about that. Individual therapy, short or long term, parent-infant therapy, assessment, diagnosis or counseling, licensed psychiatry, support to professional, training in transcultural issue or research. So for the group setting, we invite the extended family. These families, migrant families, are referred by professional, and the professional are invited to participate, interpreter participate, and a group of therapists. Different languages, different cultural background and nationality are represented. It's what we call a polyglot group with a multiplicity of hypotheses. So you can see the group setting with the principal therapist, the interpreter, the family patient, the co-therapist, the referral team, and the children that are in the center. The table with toys and for children, they can play or they can draw. So you know the table in the center of the group. And these transcultural concerns are also very important in mental health, in humanitarian fields, because we can't help without these transcultural dimensions. So, for example, it's what we make with Médecins Sans Frontières, Doctors Without Borders, with mental health activity in different, a lot of different countries in the world. So, in mental health in these NGOs have different challenges. First, operational challenges to assess need, to deliver care and to take into account transcultural issues. Also research challenges, measuring program efficacy, measuring validity in this humanitarian field, and research in crisis situation. So there is three levels of intervention in the community with groups and psychiatric intervention. So what are the lessons from the humanitarian field? To assess the local resources that are available, it's very important. To support cultural meaningful practices, to accept way of representing the need of children, to accept a cultural interpretation of symptoms of dreams, for example, to accept the mourning of healing ritual, because the patient, the family need these rituals to accept their way to be resilient, to cope with adversity, and to cooperate with parents, society, and local professionals. So last but not least, to do the conclusion, I think that there is a greater recognition of cultural issues now, but there is still a lack of cultural sensitivity in health models and services. We have to take into account the cultural identity of the clinician. We have a cultural identity too. The belief, attitude and prejudice towards ethnic minorities are still very strong, even in child and adolescent psychiatry. And it's a way to treat children better, whatever their color and culture too. So I have a dream with the increasing of diversity in our society. There is an urgent need to develop and evaluate transcultural tools in order to address the specific challenges of working with children of immigrants all around the world. and to work with children all around the world where needs are tremendous. You can see a transcultural film with an English traduction, J'ai rêvé d'une grande étendue d'eau, I dreamt of a vast stretch of water. This film is in Amazon. Thanks very much for your attention. And if necessary, I give you a small biography and films. And thanks very much.